Hi everyone. So now in the next video, what we are going to talk about is object functions, function prototype and all. I have already talked about these concepts in length in my previous videos. I will just quickly go through them, what all possible questions can be. Okay, coming to the previous video, I actually forgot to pass this argument. So I'm just correcting that. You have to pass I here, obviously. This is a ify block. So here, if we execute this expression, this is what we are getting, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And when we just comment this out, then you can see we are going to get 5. Okay. Now, coming to our next set of questions, which we are going to discuss, is about prototype. And prototype is not a simple topic which can be just talked in single video. But I'm already aware that you might have already discussed these things or worked on these things. So function prototype, you just define a functions and now you can keep adding the prototype properties, right? Now another thing is, just adding the prototype is obviously will give you advantage, because this will maintain single copy in the memory. So when you are creating an object of percent class, all the objects will be shared, all the objects will share this single prototype copy. This is why we create a prototype properties. And when there is a new function, you have a function person class 2, that can also inherit the prototype properties of a person class. That is called prototypal inheritance. Similarly, we have object, we are creating one object from another object and inheriting the properties which object 1 is having. So we are creating a proto chain in that case. Okay. So coming to the objects, there are many questions about object shallow copy, deep copy, object copy, reference copy, what is a spread operator, what is object.assign, does a shallow copy or a deep copy. All these are actually shallow copy. For deep copy, you have to actually, deep copy means even the nested object which you are copying, that doesn't copy with the reference. That is totally a purely new copy. So if you are changing any property, nested property also from source object, it will not impact the target object. Okay, how can you manually do the copy, recursive copy of object A into object B just by looking into each and every properties? That can be done. And you can create a new object out of it, which is not a reference copy, because you are actually creating a pure new object by iterating a single object, each and every nested property. But if you do object.assign, create a new object from the existing object, that will be a shallow copy for the nested objects. Okay. Similarly, spread operator also does the same thing. So for doing a deep copy, you can actually use a deep clone, or you can write your own method to just iterate onto the object and copy each and every property to the new object. It's also the same thing. Okay. Or you can actually do the stringify and json.parse that object. Okay, so there are many questions on the object, how, what is the proto chain, what is the prototype chain, how we access the proto, what is the underscore proto, right? What is the function prototype, what function prototype contains, right? When you are writing a function, and when I'm doing const ob is equal to new person class, what actually happening in this particular case, we are actually creating the object of this function. So it will create a new object, and this context of that new object will point to this object. Okay. So when you are actually calling a new keyword, when you are passing the new keyword and function name, it means you are creating an object. So it will return a new object with these two values assigned in this context. Okay. So if you try to do just object dot underscore proto, that will point to the prototype of this function. Every function has a prototype, every object has a proto. So there are a lot of concepts around it, how to deal with the proto, prototype. So you should be good at. I will not be covering each and everything in depth, because I have covered these many times in my playlist. Like if you talk about JavaScript tutorials or JavaScript interview questions, I have already covered what is prototype chain, what is a proto chain, how we extend the properties of one object into another object, how we copy the prototype properties of function A into function B. Okay, so that's all in this video, guys. Thanks everyone.